Senator, weighing in on President-elect Trump's reported pick for Secretary of State, Exxon CEO Rex Tillerson, who has worked closely with Russian President Vladimir Putin. Trump says that's an asset. Will the U.S. Senate agree? With me here to discuss this and much more, Radio America and The Blaze host Dana Lash, former Democratic governor of Michigan Jennifer Granholm, CNN political commentator Alice Stewart, and Mark Morial, president and CEO of the National Urban League and former mayor. So thank you one and all for being here. I appreciate it. So, Alice, let me start with you. Tillerson and ExxonMobil, clearly there is a business relationship right there, and you heard Senator Cardin earlier in the show say that the next Secretary of State has to represent America's interests, not the interests of the oil and gas industry. Do you think this could be a problem for confirmation hearings?
Well, I think, first off, no official decision has been made, although it does appear he is the strong, likely right candidate for this, and we have to wait for Donald Trump to make the announcement. But look, it's one thing when you're a CEO of a major corporation and you're dealing with foreign leaders selling goods and services. That's one role. As opposed to, as Secretary of State, dealing with foreign leaders when you're representing America's best interests. They're two completely different hats, two different responsibilities, and I trust that he will be able to wear the right hat as Secretary of State. And he's proven to be a strong leader for his company, and I truly believe he would be a strong leader for America.
But you know what, Jake? I mean, as we say, personnel is policy. And when somebody has spent 30 years of their life advocating for an oil company, advocating for increasing profits for that oil company, which is perfectly fine, Donald Trump is not with him in all of the thousands of small decisions that any leader who's appointed to the cabinet has to make on a daily basis. Those small decisions are what bend the arc of policy. So having somebody like Rex Tillerson, who has had, who's billions of dollars of investment in Russia, who's got 10 joint ventures as Exxon CEO with Russian state-owned companies, mm-hmm, who has been a clear ally of Putin. This is a gift, really, you know, to Vladimir Putin.
I think, Jake, the important thing is there's got to be a full, complete, thorough confirmation process. And I think what comes into play is transparency around Exxon's dealings, not only in Russia, but all over the world.
Right.
The public has a right to know what entanglements are involved with the secretary designee, or the putative secretary designee.
Dana, some of the strongest voices voicing concern about Tillerson are coming from Senate Republicans. Senator Lindsey Graham told the Washington Post, "I don't know the man much at all, but let's put it this way. If you received an award from the Kremlin, Order of Friendship, then we're going to have some talking."
Can you do it with a better accent?
Because I'm hearing you say that in Lindsey Graham's accent right now.
It's better in the original South Carolina.
Exactly. Criticisms of Lindsey Graham aside, look, the confirmation hearings are going to be tough. Is he going to make it through? I don't know. And it's true. It's not an official decision yet. At the same time, look, I understand the concerns. I also understand that I think anybody who comes from the private sector is going to be staunchly looked at. It's weird because I feel like every single person who's being selected, if they come from the private sector, the fact that they come from the private sector is almost invalidating them for consideration. Administration by many people in politics, so we need to get over that hill immediately. But the thing is, if there is evidence that does exist as to why this individual would be a wrong fit for the top diplomat, as to why this individual should not be considered to be part of this, a part of the cabinet, then by all means, that's what the confirmation hearings are for. That's when you bring your A game. So I'm open to being convinced.
So I mean, I think one of the things that's interesting about it is it comes within the context of Russia. Looming large, Nosferatu style, behind the U.S. election. And former Congressman Joe Walsh, a Republican of Illinois, tweeted about the Russian hacking, Russian meddling, quote, "I'm a Trump supporter, but if Russia messed with our election to help Hillary lose, I'd be pissed and I'd demand something be done about it." Do you think, obviously, there's no evidence that what Russia did changed the outcome of the election, right?
True.
But do you think that the tone from people like the president-elect is right? Because there are a lot of people like Congressman Walsh who support Donald Trump, but also don't like the idea of Putin getting involved in this.
Well, first and foremost, it's important to notice there's no credible information out there or evidence to say that this is the Russian government that's responsible for these hacks.
As opposed to Russian hackers.
Russian hackers, it would The IP address does indicate clearly it comes from Russia, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's the Russian government. But there are concerns with Russia, and there have been concerns with Putin. That's why it was frustrating when President Obama criticized Mitt Romney for voicing his concerns. That's why there was frustration when Hillary Clinton tried to hit the reset, which was a complete failure. I think we will have strong opposition to Russia. We understand the dangers involved there, and I think Donald Trump will set the right tone, specifically with who he picks as Secretary of State.
This is outrageous and dangerous, and sets a bad precedent that a foreign nation could in any way seek to influence an American election. From the beginning of the founding of this nation, there were controls put in place. That's why we have limitations on who can be president. That's why there's the emoluments clause. We need to know as American people whether there was an effort by Russia, abetted by Russia, encouraged by Russia, financed by Russia to affect this election. Because what we don't want is to turn this into every country in the world has a campaign office in the United States behind their intelligence agency trying to influence the outcome. Congress must thoroughly investigate.
Right. I mean, this is really the biggest story of the election other than Donald Trump's victory, which is a foreign, not just any foreign country. It is Russia trying to come in and influence in some way this election.
And it might be first, just to undermine American democracy. It might not be to try to...
But that's what they do.
Right.
So
that's
first
why you've got to investigate.
Second, first it's the election, and then what? Their cyber warfare comes in and tries to undermine our intelligence, and then it's what? Our defense systems.
Yeah.
This is Russia's M.O. They want to undermine democracies in Europe so they can expand their geographic footprint. They want to weaken NATO, and they want a weak America. And that's what they think they've got in Donald Trump.
I was not a cheerleader of the president-elect during the primary, for sure. But to me, it feels like there's more than one undermining going on. I feel like we see this every single time a Democrat loses a general election, that there's some sort of narrative, Jake, that floats out there that somehow discredits the vote
and
invalidates.
Thing,
but the CIA just set a general consensus. I mean, I'm open to specifics, and so far I haven't
have
seen that. I do agree with this, though. And here's the one thing that I do believe warrants some sort of investigation. Regardless of what everyone's party identification is, you have an organization, the DNC, which was hacked.
Right.
Now, whether or not this affected the general election, that remains to be seen. And I'm not going to be convinced on a consensus, particularly when the FBI already did a forensics investigation into this and cleared it. But the big point is that you have an organization, the DNC, which was hacked. Regardless our party politics, we should be able to say you in the United States are free to have an organization where you're able to practice your politics and you're able to have your free speech without it being hacked by a foreign entity. On that particular point, I am open to an investigation. But it's to me, it's invalid to say that this just rocked the whole entire general election.